A warm welcome to all the viewers for the course Advanced Manufacturing Technology, AME 702, and myself Thiapal, Assistant Professor of Department of Mechanical Engineering, is going to give a brief lecture on 3D printing. Well, already in my previous lecture, I have already discussed about various types of rapid prototyping processes. As you know, that today's industry demand much more higher accuracy level rate for any product. So as per the requirement, maybe when initially we used to do with the conventional machining method, but with the demand of the market, we have moved towards the non-traditional machining processes to get the desired object or to get the desired product, where we are getting much more higher level of accuracy in the product. But with the passage of time, now the rapid prototyping is also playing a very important role in today's manufacturing market. So one of the process of rapid prototyping is also 3D printing. And all of you know that already we have discussed in my previous lecture about the additional process as well as removal process as well as the virtual process. Okay, so subtractive process we have already gone through, and we have also talked about the additive process, but we have not gone through in the details. So today in this particular lecture, we are going to discuss in details about the additive process, we are going to discuss about the subtractive process, as well as we are going to discuss about the 3D printing. So without any further delay, let's go to the next slide. That is the introduction of additive manufacturing and subtractive manufacturing. Well, we are talking about manufacturing, and you can see that manufacturing is broadly classified into two sections, that is additive process, another is subtractive process. So if I talk about the additive rapid prototyping operation, then I must say it's all about to build parts in layer. They are summarized, isn't it? And in order to visualize the approach used, it is beneficial to think of construction of a loaf of a bread by stacking individual slices on top of each other. Now all of the process described in the section build parts slice by slice, and the main difference between the various processes lies in the approach taken to produce the individual slice. Now rapid prototyping in this approach requires operation, I mean to say requires operator input in the setup of the proper computer file and in the initiation of the production process. It should be also recognized that the steps up and finishing operations are very labor intensive, and that the production time is only a part of the time required to obtain a prototype. But if I talk about the subtractive process, then making a prototype has traditionally involved manufacturing process using a variety of tooling and machine. So usually it takes anywhere from week to 1 month, depending on the part and complexity. Until recently, this approach has arrived or required high skill labor or operator using conventional metal cutting and finishing machinery to execute operation one by one until the prototype was finished. But today, subtractive processes use computer-based technologies to speed up the processes. Now, essential to this approach are the following technology. One is computer-based drafting package, where the produced 3D dimensional representation of part. Second, interpretation software, which can translate the CAD file into a format usable by manufacturing software. And third, manufacturing software, which is capable of planning the machine operation required to produce the desired shape. And fourth, it is computer numerical control machinery, which is capable or which has the capability that is required to the manufacture the parts. So what I was talking, that four approaches have been involved in subtractive manufacturing. So first, if I talk about it, is computer based drafting package. Okay, second, if I talk, then I am talking about interpolation or interpretation. Software. Third, I am talking about manufacturing software. And fourth, I am talking about computer numerical control machine, that is formerly known as CNC machine. So these are the four new approaches or essential approaches that are used by subtractive processes. So subtractive process, what I told, this is, you can see this is a block. This is a block of material, and you can see material are removed to gain this particular shape. That's why you have obtained a particular product here. So subtractive manufacturing, what it state is that it creates a product by removing section from block of material. So it generates waste through the excess material that is removed. Next, I was talking about the CNC approach, subtractive approach. So this is computerized numerical control machining, and this is basically a subtractive manufacturing that removes section from a block of material by cutting or drilling the excess material away. And this is your additive process. So this is the additive process product, but how it is formed, you can see so many slices are there. So one by layer they are deposited one after another to gain this particular shape. So additive manufacturing, basically what it's do is that it creates a product through adding materials to the object. So you can see here adding of material is occurring. So add material layer by layer until printing is finished, and it allows for complex and intricate design also. Now manufacturing, we have already discussed about additive and subtractive. So additive process is much more efficient, but here it is less efficient. Now additive process conserve resources, but in subtractive process you can see wastage of resources occur because it is removing the material. Additive process is saving your time, whereas subtractive process is time consuming. Now have a look for subtractive versus additive process. Subtractive means you are removing the material from the block. So this is your raw material. After performing the machining, what is that? You are obtaining the 3D object, but similarly you are getting lots of wastage. But in additive process, you are using this material, and with the help of this particular nozzle or particular heads, you are ejecting the material and forming layer after layer to get the desired product. But you see the wastage is also very minimum, or you can say it is negligible too. Now if I go for additive manufacturing, then manufacturing is a process in which raw materials are transferred into good finish. So these are the properties that additive manufacturing basically holds. One is technology that can make anything. Elements may constrain imposed by conventional manufacturing also. Next is that it leads to more market opportunities. You can see so many opportunities means they are basically getting for additive manufacturing. Next is increased applications such as 3D faxing sender scan, 3D object in cross section, and send out the digital images in layer. And then the reception receive the layered image and uses the advanced machining to fabricate the 3D object, or additive manufacturing machine to fabricate the object. Now, basically the process of joining material makes an object three-dimensional, and it is usually performed layer by layer. So commonly it is known as 3D printing. And manufacturing components with virtual with no geometrical limitations or tool. Now, additive manufacturing are basically used as an additive process and designed for manufacturing to manufacturing for design also. Now, distinguish from traditional subtractive machining technique, obviously it is no removal of material is occurring, so it is not occurring. You are getting the desired shape, but actually what? Deposition of material layer by layer, you are depositing the material. So what are the general principles of this particular process? One is modeling, two is printing, and finally it is finishing. So if I go for modeling, at first what you are doing? You are doing a 3D CAD model. Then you are converting the CAD file into STL file. Then with the help of slicing software, you are just slicing that thing. Here you can see layer, slice, and tool path has been mentioned. And with the help of 3D printer, you are depositing the material layer by layer. And finally, you are getting your desired output, that is your 3D object. What is general principle of modeling? It is just an additive manufacturing which takes virtual blueprints from computer-aided design or animation model software. And then it slices them into digital cross-section for the machine to successfully use as a guideline for printing. Now printing, what you are doing basically? To perform a print, the machine reads the design and lay down successful layer of liquid or even powder or sheet materials to build the model from a series of cross-section. Now this layer, which corresponds to virtual cross-section from the CAD model, are joined together to be automated fused to create the final shape. And the primary advantage of this technique is ability to create almost any shape or geometrical features. So you can see this is your model. You can see deposition of material has occurs layer after layer. Now comes about the finishing process. Though the printer produced resolution is sufficient for many applications, but still printing a slightly oversized version of the desired object in standard resolution, and they remove the material with a higher resolution, like including the subtractive process to get higher resolution object. Now if I talk about the algorithm, then pre-process, product part, and post-process. So you can see pre-process means you are developing the CAD model, converting it into STL file, and producing the part here with the help of 3D printer. And then post-process is there. If you require much more finishing of the product, you can go with the post-processing. Now additive manufacturing process chain. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is the cup you have generated. But behind this, so many processes are involved. Number one process, it is the conceptualization and CAD. Number two, conversion of STL file. Number three, that is transfer and manipulation of STL file on additive manufacturing machine. Number four is your machine setup. Number five, is building up the product. Number 6, you are removing the part and cleaning up. Number 7, it is post-processing part. That means you want to go for a cleaning or some printing or painting. Then you can go for the post-process part. And further, and the last is 8. That is your application of the product. So you can see these are the steps that is involved to get a product from additive manufacturing process. So basically this is a complete chain. So basically if I ask, how does additive manufacturing work? 3D printer are machine that produce a physical model from digital data by printing layer by layer. And it can be make physical object either by CAD program or scanned with 3D scanner. Now look at the file. How the digital file basically starts. Number one, it is in the 3D world, so 3D printer needs to have some instruction for what to print. Number two, it need a file. The file must be a CAD file. Number three, the software slices the design into thousands of horizontal layers, so that you can further deposit the material in layer by layer for your proper instruction. Number four, this layer will be printed one atop the other until the 3D object is done. So number five, you can see a perforated platform is positioned just below the surface of a vat of a liquid photo curable polymer. Number six, ultraviolet rays are allowed to pass over the surface to harden. Number seven, the perforated platform is then lowered very slightly and another slice is traced, cut and hardened by the laser. And number eight, it is another slice is then created and another until the entire object is completed. So this is your proper setup that has to be maintained for this particular process. So just have a look, interesting. This is the world's first 3D printed jet engine, through which we have obtained various 3D products of additive manufacturing. Now if I talk about the additive manufacturing process, then it has been classified into 7 categories. One is your vat photopolymerization, or which is very commonly known as stereolithography. I have already explained you in my previous lecture. Then this is material jetting, binder jetting, material extrusion, powder bed fusion, sheet lamination and directed energy deposition. Now we are going to have a look for introduction for 3D printer. Basically it was produced by Z Corporation by USA, and the core technology invented and painted by MIT. The materials they have preferred was starch and plaster formulation. The model they have introduced was Z400, that is entry level and education purpose. Z406 by 510 for using the color printer builds, and Z810 for large build volume. So what I was talking, it was 3D printer. Z Corporation, Burlington by MA, and the printing head deposit binder solution on build power. The accuracy level is 0.076 millimeter, and wax and arsenate and epoxies are various material they prefer. So this is a schematic illustration of the 3D printing. You can see the powder is here. So you can see what it is doing. The with the help of this jet, the binder are being ejected. And you can see the piston movement, it is coming slowly, slowly downward. Because you can see, as this is moving, the powder is there, it is getting binder, so deposition of material is occurring. So now it has got one layer. Now intermediate state, you can see, slowly, slowly it is getting deposited. Last layer printed, so this is the last layer printed, and finished part you are have obtained it here. So this is the schematic illustration of three-dimensional printing process. So this is your 3D printer. So this is a powder feed roller that is helping you to feed you powder. This is a nozzle is there which provide the binder solution. Basically this is your printing head, and finally a glue, excessive glue is getting to remove, and this is getting upward direction because slowly slowly it is providing the powder to get binded with the binder to get the desired product. So 3D inkjet printing. Parts are built upon a platform which is situated in a bin full of powder material. An inkjet printer head selectively deposits or prints a binder fluid to fuse the powder together in the desired area. Unbound powder material remains to support the parts. The platform is lowered slowly, more powder is added and leveled, and the process is repeated. So finished part can be infiltrated with the wax, glue or any sealant to improve the durability and surface quality, that is surface finish. So typically layer thickness are in order of 0.1 millimeter, and this process is very fast, produces part with a slight grainy surface also. And there are also other different types of 3D printing available in the market which gives a very good accuracy level. This is the 3D inkjet printer. Binder is provided and deposition and level of bindable powder has been provided. So what are the process? Process involved the local bonding of the starch powder by the binder using an inkjet. This was patented by MIT. The characteristics are very highly build speed, easily handling, binder available in different color, infiltration necessary, ideal for fast visualization. So this is the process involvement. You can see this is the process principle, this is the 3D facilities, this is the mobile, the cover up, and you can see the visualization model of a pump also. So process setup basically consists of four steps. Spread a layer of powder, print the cross section of the part, spread another layer of powder, parts are printed without no support to remove. So this is the post-processing if you want, that is cleaning the excess powder. You can blow some air. Glue is used for infiltrate and sanding process is performed to give a good surface quality. So next process is involving painting. If you want to paint, first you have to spray. Then you are using the paint brush. Then you can go for coating. And finally, this is your finished product of your calculator of this particular over page. This is your phone back cover. So you can see these are the finished product. Now we are moving to finished product. Disassembling all this thing, you can see. And this is after assembling. The front portion of your calculator, and this is the back cover of your mobile. So material they are preferring are starch powder, that is jet corpse. Other manufacturing offer system for ceramics or metal also. What are the advantages? Basically it is having high speed because layer printed in a second. It is very versatile because used for automotive, aerospace, footwear, packaging, etc. It's very easy to operate because it is very straightforward. No wastage of material, so it can be recycled. Next, color, you can enable complex color scheme also. Now what are the disadvantages? First of all, regarding part size, you can obtain up to 200 into 250 into 200 millimeter. Resolution is 600 dpi in XY direction, but the facility cost is too high. Limited functional part, that is, models are very weak. Limited material, you can go for starch and plaster based only. Poor surface finish, for that you need that post processing process. Next we are talking about the comparative overview of additive manufacturing. Well, design flexibility is there, but cost of geometric complexity is also there. You can obtain dimensional accuracy too, and no need of assemblage also. But time and cost efficiency is in product run. So these are the comparative overview of additive manufacturing. Now we are talking about design flexibility. Almost any shape can be manufactured. So no constraints such as fixture, cutter, reachability, then diverse tooling, etc. like in traditional manufacturing, they are basically involved. It is easy to make changes in the model by just editing the CAD model. Moreover, it is capable of producing varieties of product without making setup changes also. Now let's have a look for cost of geometric complexity. Very less influence on cost of product due to complexity of the product. Easy to create complex shape. It can produce part by just using the CAD software package. Now let's talk about the dimensional accuracy. Now the dimensional accuracy determines the deviation of the finished model when compared to the original digital model. Very less or negligible tolerance are provided in additive manufacturing. Parts to nanoscale accuracy can also be manufactured with the precise 3D printer also. Now no need of assemblage, obviously, because you are doing a additive process, so any complex shape can be produced, so assemblage is not required because it is capable of producing single part assemblies. The parts and joints are printed in a place and are suspended by support material that must be removed in post-processing. When compared with traditional machining, it reduces the cost of assembling the part also. Now let's discuss about time and cost efficiency in production run. Unlike most of the traditional machining process, additive manufacturing is suitable for low volume production. On demand and on site production in additive manufacturing, it reduces the inventory cost and time required. Very less material wastage as compared to other manufacturing processes also occur. The material that has been preferred for using in additive manufacturing process. So let's have a discussion. Plastic is preferred in 3D printing. Currently, plastic are the most widely used material in the additive manufacturing. And most important one are also listed below. That is ABS, that is arsenolanitril, butadiene, styrene or ligoplastic, a very common choice for 3D printing. And next is PLA, that is polylactic acid. It is available in soft and hard grades, which is becoming very popular and making overtake of ABS in near future too. Now we are talking about the metal. Some metal that is used in 3D printing, usually steel, stainless steel, titanium, gold and silver. While as others are preferred as bio-ink, which is comprises steel, cell and cell from a patent. And bone material, that is bone material comprises of silicon, calcium phosphate and zinc. Where are the application for rapid prototyping? That is model and parts reaches or research purpose can be easily manufactured when required. Easy to make changes in the model as per the research proceeding. For food, that is Cornell Creative Machine Lab is making food items such as chocolate, candy paste, pizza using the 3D printing technology since 2012. Apparel, that is the products such as customized shoes, cloth, eyewear are being manufactured. Even Nike is using 3D printing for manufacturing the Vapor Leisure Talon football shoe for players of American football. If I talk about the vehicles, in 2010, RB became the first car whose whole body was 3D printed. It was done by USA Engineer Group, Colic and the company Stratasy. In the year 2040, Swedish supercar manufacturer was denoted and it was manufactured a supercar having a many 3D printing mechanical parts in it. Next come over the firearm. Defense arms such as gun, rifle and safety equipment has also been manufactured by additive manufacturing. In the year 2012, USA-based group that is Defense Distributed design of work plastic gun that could be downloaded and reproduced by anybody with a 3D printer. In the year 2013, Solid Concept based in Austin, Texas, USA succeeded in manufacturing first working metal gun. In medical background, if you have a look, then nowadays medical devices specifies implant, hearing aids, dental product and pills are made manufactured by additive manufacturing. In the year 2014, in the month of October, 5-year-old girl born without fully formed finger on her left hand. And the first child in UK to have the prosthetic hand made up of 3D printer. So these are the things that you can see for medical background also. In August 2015, USA Food and Drug Administration provide 3D printed pills which allows very porous pill to produce, which enable high drug dose in a single pill, which dissolve quickly and can be ingested easily. Bioprinting is also there. This is one of the application where refers to the manufacturing of artificial biological organs, body parts working like original one. And this also, in this process, layer of living cell are deposited on a gel medium or sugar matrix and slowly built up to form a three-dimensional structure including the vascular system. Now the first production system for 3D tissue printing was delivered in the year 2009, which was based on by Novagen bioprinting technology. In the year 2013, Chinese scientists began printing ears, liver, kidneys without living tissue. With living tissues. In the year 2014, the researcher of the University of Hasselt in Belgium had successfully printed a new jawbone for an 83-year-old woman. If I talk about the space, you can see 3D printer to the International Space Station. They have generated a SpaceX, okay, with zero gravity. And in NASA, in ML CAD drawing for the socket range to astronaut abroad. The European Space Agency plan to deliver a new advanced portable on board 3D printer to the International Space Station. So if I go with the education and research, then scientific instrument replicates the historical item internal organ of human body, 3D model of molluscus, and chemical compound can also be printed in classroom laboratories to study them. So these are the industrial application, apparel, automobile and medical parts. See how complex step product has been generated by the 3D printing. If I go for the medical implantation, dental crown, see you go for implantation, dental, this is implantation, then you go for dental crown, then you go for this particular product. Socioculture and application, so this is the 3D printing polished nickel steel model. Education researcher are also going with this particular process. So what are the advantages? If I go for a very gesture portion, then I must say it elimination of design constraint, allow parts to be produced with complex geometry with no additional cost, build up speed, flexibility in design, no expensive tooling requirement, dimensional accuracy is there, wide range of materials are there, they are using polymer metal ceramics, well suited to the manufacturer with a high value replacement, and it also repair parts. It is preferred for green manufacturing, clean, and it is going for minimal wastage also. Now if I go for the limitation, then first of all the part size, because you cannot generate a very huge product. Productivity series, that is for small size parts, size up to 25,000 parts per year are already possible. If you choose for material, then no weldable metal cannot be proceed. If you go for material property, then additive manufacturing always tends to show anisotropy in a z-axis. The density of 99.9 can be reached. There can be some residual internal porosity also. Mechanical properties are usually superior to cast part, but in general inferior to the wrought part. So future of additive manufacturing is going to be a game changer. Bridge gap between the cyberspace and the physical world. It will be used to change the world as we know it, before you know it. So technology and research people can go with this particular process because the cost effectiveness must customize the complex product. It reduces the material wastage and energy consumption also. Educational and training also, there is some sort of limitations because I hold great potential for the promotion science technology. And the availability of low-cost 3D printer equipment is creating the opportunity for additive manufacturing. So what are the current barrier and the challenges? First of all, personal fabrication versus mass manufacturing. When compared with the traditional manufacturing process, additive manufacturing is economic when parts to be manufactured in low volume. But when it comes to customize the product manufacturing, additive manufacturing is best suited. If I go for the building's capability versus layer resolution, increased layer resolution decreases the layer thickness to be printed, and decrease in layer thickness increases the surface finish as well as the number of layer. The large number of layer increases the total building time. If I go for material heterogeneity and structure reliability, while consumer goods are comprised of wide variety of material that render different behavior and functionalities, the material selection of the additive manufacturing system is quite limited, and product from additive manufacturing system suffer from anisotropic mechanical properties due to internal layer bonding deficiencies. And most of the simple 3D printer are capable of printing single material at a time. Multi-material printing system is limited due to uncertain behavior at the material interface. So if I go for summary, then I can see that the process of joining material to make an object from three-dimensional model data, usually by layer by layer. Traditional subtractive machining technique really on the removal of the material by the methods such as cutting or milling has an advantage over the traditional machining process. Seven processes of additive manufacturing are associated. Additive manufacturing is the verge of the shift from a pure rapid prototyping technology, and manufacturing of metal component with virtual no geometrical limitation or tool offers new ways to increase productivity performance as well as establish a new process and revenue streams. So thank you for listening the video and watching the video. So I would like to request all of you that if you have liked the video, then please stay connected with me. And in the next lecture, we are going to upload about the lecture of CNC machining. Thank you very much.